so obviously I'm Zach Garcia, and what matters to me a lot is martial arts. And I currently do martial arts over at Six Levels Orlando over there. And one thing that martial arts has taught me more than a lot of other things and any moves that it is to be confident. And I'm not the tallest guy or the biggest guy, but I know that I can handle myself. So yeah, that's the great thing about martial arts. It's not all about fighting, it also teaches you how to be confident. Now let's talk about confidence. Confidence, according to Google, is a feeling of self-assurance arising from one's appreciation and of one's own abilities and qualities. So my qualities are that I'm short, but I'm fast, and I go back a bunch. So like, if I'm close to my opponent and I stay close to them and I'm on the inside, they can't really hit me because I'm like right here. And even if they did hit me, it wouldn't hurt as much because I'm right there. But it takes courage and confidence to get to there because you don't want to get hit. So now let's talk about, Mayweather and Pacquiao. Pacquiao, he's 5'5" and 144 pounds, so he's not a big guy. Mayweather's 5'8" and 151 pounds, but all their techniques and stuff, they're really good. So martial arts can help you with fitness as well, and everybody needs to be fit to live a long, healthy life. And if you train every day in martial arts, that helps with muscle growth and stuff like stamina. And if you do kickboxing or shadow boxing is just like boxing without a partner, that can help you because, it helps with the core. Because you're crunched down and stuff like that. And then if you're not much of a kicker, you can use this, which is... Jiu-Jitsu is more of like wrestling, so you can flip people. And just doing that is like a workout on its own sometimes. So, I train every Saturday in MMA. So now let's talk about shin conditioning. I'm moving to Thailand in August, and I'm going to be practicing Muay Thai. And Muay Thai fighters over there, they usually clash shins and stuff, and you don't want to break a shin. So they condition by hitting against wood, bamboo, tree, steel, and that creates microfractures. And these microfractures, they hurt a lot, but they don't like stop you from walking, and it's very painful. I'm not going to do that. And they heal, and they create. I'm not there yet. But like, this is what it looks like on the inside. So they're little fractures, and yeah, they heal through a process called cortical remodeling, which is this, and the bone on the where it used to be. That bone becomes harder than the existing bone, and it could be as hard as a stone, they said. And so you're able to like crack stuff in half, like bones, fats, stuff like that. So what made me want to do martial arts is this movie. I remember coming outside of the movie, I told my dad that I really wanted to be like it, and my dad said, okay, let's make it happen. So that month, I went over to Victory Martial Arts in Dr. Phillips, and over there I trained for 2 years, and then I moved to Koei, so I went to the same company but different location, and that's where I learned how to do flips and cool kicks and stuff. But then I left because of reasons, and now I'm over here at Six Levels, and it's been the best martial arts experience of my life. That's John Berg, and he's a really good coach. It's like a good environment, it's more realistic fighting, and it helps you with jiu-jitsu. And so they teach fitness, jiu-jitsu, and MMA. And he was trained, my coach was trained by Helio and Royce, and Helio was the founder of Brazilian martial arts, jiu-jitsu, my bad. And Royce trained him, so that's Thailand. I'm gonna be going there in August, like I said, so I'm not looking forward to shin training, but I am looking forward to this, and that's my presentation.